always red? B, how many of you, okay, so there is somebody right there. B, how many of you feel that it's okay if your opinions remain unheard at all times? Nobody, right? This is because you wish to exercise your freedom of speech as a matter of right at all times. Good morning to the esteemed panel and dear audience. I'm Ria, and today it gives me immense pleasure to be here exercising my right to freedom of speech and oppose the motion in the House today that believes it is more of a privilege. In order to substantiate my argument, I would be talking broadly about three major points. First, where I prove how it is an already established natural right. Second, as a legal right. And third, how it is an important component for social upheaval, revolution, and change. Coming to my first point, natural right, which basically refers to a right that is bestowed to individuals, human beings per se, just by the virtue of being an animal. Speech and expression is a definite part of it. It was only after the coming up of social contract theories and political institutions that we began to saw some kind of infringement or say control over it. But that doesn't mean that a natural right will cease to exist after a particular point of time. Coming to a legal aspect to it, I would like to reiterate Article 19(1) of the Constitution. Apart from stating that freedom of speech is a fundamental